Well, it's a rivalry that usually could separate families and certainly will do that with friends. Can't tell you how excited we are to be there. Our on-the-road coverage in Eugene for the Civil War. Mike Am, Yogi Roth, you'll actually be on the call for this one. This feels different than it would have felt probably a week ago with Oregon's loss. This is still a team, though, that's battling for not only a Pac-12 championship, but still a spot in the Rose Bowl. Can't overlook a team that certainly could score some points in the Beavs.
Oh, this is going to be fun. I mean, get to hang out with you pretty much all day. Yeah, we got a pregame show, you're going to be there. We got the game, postgame, etc. And a lot is at stake. You reference Oregon. Justin Herbert, he's never played in a title game in high school or in college. He's guaranteed to play in the Pac-12 title game. He's never played in a huge bowl game. He got a Rose Bowl on the line. How did this team bounce back? Clearly an embarrassing, unexpected loss to Arizona State a week ago. And the way they played on defense is what I'm most excited about. Double-digit missed tackles, not the type of defense we've been accustomed to seeing all season long. And now I got to go up against one of the top passers in this conference and somebody I keep hearing chirps about. NFL, Jake Luton, sleepy late-round pick potentially. So I love everything this has to offer at Autzen Stadium.
All right, what about on the flip side? This is an Oregon State team. It's probably kicking themselves because it's now two games that you could point to. Last week, Washington State and Hawaii matchup, they close out and they hold on to a lead late. We're already talking about this team bowling. Can you imagine they get that bowl eligibility against Oregon on the road in Eugene?
Oh, totally. I talked to some members of their program earlier today, and they know what they need to do. I mean, if you've ever been to Autzen Stadium, it's crazy. You got to start fast. You got to get some momentum going early. And I think they need to run the football. And I think that's actually kind of an advantage for Oregon State. Their offensive line, when you watch them play, Mike, they played a lot of football. Sure. It's been pretty much the same guys all year long. And they moved lines of scrimmages. Regardless of whatever team they played, they've done well. Both running backs healthy for the first time. You could argue all season long, Jamar Jefferson is at his very best.
Looked awesome.
Isaiah Hodgins, your boy, he can get downfield. But Brandon Ayuk, Frank Darby got downfield a week ago. So I think for Oregon State, when they watch the ASU film, they're sitting back saying, hey, we can move the ball right here. So I just think this first quarter, man, it is going to be, it is an awesome way for us to end the regular season.
Yeah, and once again, you can catch it on Pac-12 Network, the pregame show, 12 p.m. Pacific time, as soon as the game is done. We are going extended coverage in Eugene. I know you're jacked. I'm jacked. We'll see you up there on Saturday.